On Deji 360, we don't just ask the questions.
What is wrong with amending the Constitution the way the National Assembly members have been doing it?
We seek answers.
Constitution is constituent.
Our problem is not lack of laws. Our problem is lack of the will power to implement our laws.
Answers that provide clarity.
While we negotiate, we should try to make it a point that the girls must be complete.
The clarity you need to make informed judgment so that you can make the right decision and take action.
People are saying it is you politicians that are responsible for this, that you are the reason why this is happening.
All these dullards that call themselves governors in this country?
I wish we had people like Tony at the National Assembly.
God forbid that I go to join that
Deji 360, providing clarity to issues.
All right, welcome back. Now, Nigeria's ruling All Progressives Congress has now seemingly become two, so it seems. A new faction to be called the Reformed All Progressives Congress has broken away from the party after many months of dispute on how the affairs of the party is being run. The faction is now being led by Buba Galadima, a former national secretary of the CPC and one of the figures instrumental to the merger of the CPC and ACN back in 2014. Now, the group cites irregularities in the party's primaries as one of the key reasons for their decision to leave the APC. At a press conference in Abuja, Galadima, who is a former ally of President Muhammadu Buhari, also criticized the current government for failing to provide proper leadership for Nigeria. Let's take a listen to some of what he said.
Legitimacy to APC to be now known as and called Reformed APC, or otherwise called RAPC. The RAPC has constituted, have offices in all the wards, 774 local governments, and all the 36 states of the Federation. Men of courage, men of goodwill, people of impeccable character and integrity must stand up to stop the slide in our country. If we do not stand up, we may wake up one day and find no Nigeria at the rate we are going. But I want to say something, that as we constitute ourselves, and as we have the support of the people, I assure you that when we start to speak, at least I can't say for other parties, but I will deliver 75% of those 12.5 million votes that Buhari always garnered in every election that he stood. Most of the leading members of the defunct new PDP, CPC, ANPP, ACN, and others. The RAPC will work with like-minded political parties and groups to offer Nigeria qualitative good governance in 2019.
Now, the leadership of the All Progressives Congress has been reacting to the breakaway. The current national chairman, Adam Oshomole, has dismissed the faction, saying they are not a threat to the party. Oshomole also has been meeting with APC lawmakers in the House of Representatives as well as the Senate. Now, at that meeting with the House of Reps, Speaker Yakubu Dogara advised Oshomole to apply justice and equity to solve the current crisis. In his own statement, spokesperson of the party, Bolaji Abdullahi, dismissed the breakaway faction and insisted that the party remains united. He questioned the membership of the breakaway faction, adding that the party would launch an investigation into their legality, their membership, actually. There's also no doubt that this will serve as a big blow to the APC's chances retaining power in the 2019 election. A similar massive defection in the People's Democratic Party in the run-up to the 2015 general elections affected the then-ruling party, leading to their defeat in the polls. So will the APC suffer the same fate as a result of this division, even though we understand, well, the party is still trying, the leadership of the party now is still in negotiation and trying to convince the members of this reform APC to come back. If things don't get sorted out before the elections, then there is every chance that it could affect the chances of President Muhammadu Buhari in the next election. But let's find out more what, you know, how serious this is now. I'm now being joined on the program by Garba Umar, who is the secretary of the Buhari Youth Organization. Mr. Umar, thank you very much for joining us on the program. Let me start by asking you just how serious...
Thank you very much. Yes. You're welcome.
How serious do you think this is? How much of a setback is this for President Muhammadu Buhari and, of course, the APC?
Thank you. What I want to say, I want to respond to your earlier question before, the issue of the APC, that is the reform, so-called reform APC. You see, to me, these are not any other person than the competitionists in the party. And I am happy that they have already disassociated themselves from the body of the party, because these are the people that did the same thing to their former party, PDP, before coming to us. And all I believe is that this RPDP, they are now in a state of confusion. They don't know what to do. And to me, for them to go or to stay, it's all the same thing. Because they have already identified themselves as a black sheep. They are not with us at all. So the issue of the leader of the party or the national chairman of the party going to them, I don't think it doesn't even arise. Since they have already taken their decision to go, the best thing is to allow them go. Or if we can even help them to go, it is even better. Let them go. So that at least we have a one way. Instead of having them in the house to create confusion here and there every day, all this confusion in the party was caused by them. And then if they talk about the legality of the Congress, where were they during the Congress? These Congresses were conducted in the halls assisted across the board, across the Federation. So they should stop complaining. Most of these are stakeholders in their various state. The Konkoso is a stakeholder in Kano. Where was he when the Congress was conducted in Kano? Likewise, Saraki is a stakeholder in Kwara. Where was he? So the issue of any illegality, they are part of that Congress, whether they like it or not, because they were in the party. And all this while, what have they been doing? During the National Congress, they were in the Eagle Square. So if they are having any problem with the Congress or the party, they wouldn't have attended the
Okay, let me just quickly ask you this. There's no doubt at all. I mean, we can't refer to the reformed APC as a political party because it's actually not registered by INEC as we speak. But something I want you to react to. We've had the chairman of that group now, Buba Galadima, boast that as things stand today, that... if he decides, if he wants that, he could actually ask the National Assembly to begin impeachment proceedings against the president, that his group has got the number in the National Assembly if they want to begin impeachment proceedings against the president.
You see, Buba Galadima is a confused old man. If you look at the way Buba reacted and his manners of approach at his age, you know that he is confused. Buba came from Yobe State, where I came from. What can Buba tell us politically, morally, socially, academically? What are his contributions to his community? Buba cannot go to his community. For the first, all this insecurity, insurgency happening in the Northeast, can Buba tell us when last he visited his constituency? There is somebody that cannot even go to his constituency over 10 years, and now he is here talking about Nigeria, talking about injustice. What type of injustice? The person that cannot even identify with his people. Over 30 years, Buba has been in Kano. Buba cannot even go back to grassroots and ask his people, how are you doing? What about this insurgency? What has Buba contributed? Did Buba ever come out, either during the past administration or present administration, to ask the federal government to do something about what is happening, the killing of our people all this while? He has done nothing. So Buba is a politician that is lingering here and there. All he's doing is just to get something that he can at least feed himself. That's all. He is confused. Everybody knows that it is very conspicuous. President Buhari is quite exceptional. This man, you can look all the qualities of a leader. He possesses all the qualities of good leaders. So to me, Buba is just making noise. Where is Buba when his daughter was given an appointment as the PA to the vice president? Where was Buba when the name of his daughter came out in the board appointment? Where was he? He should have asked his daughter to resign from this government if he is sure that this government is not doing well. Why will he allow his family to be part of the government that is a pillar if it is true what he's saying? So Buba should stop deceiving people. If Buba will allow his children to go and follow the government and even accept appointment, so he should stop deceiving other people, telling them to stay out of the government. This is a clear deception. And I am so surprised. Why is he doing that? Why? Your family are there in the government. You yourself, from other angle, we know so many people that are giving Buba assistance. Buba is doing it underground. And today, the same Buba, if Buba is talking about his co-Buharis when he was in CPC, Buba accepted contracts from PDP when he was in PDP. That is a breach of trust. So to me, Buba doesn't even have that credibility to be chairman of any party. If these people really want to be people that will talk of integrity, they should have looked for another person, not
but,
Buba.
But very quickly, don't you think, I mean, because you have said, well, that they are free to go, but look, allowing these people to go, don't you think we might see a repeat of what happened to the PDP in 2015, you know, in the run-up to that election? Quite a number of the members defected to the APC. You know, they actually set up the new PDP first before defecting to the APC. Don't you think we might see a repeat of that if you say these people should go?
No. Let me tell you.
If they leave, they could harm the president's chances in the next
ACN,
election.
CPC, ANPP, there is nothing like new PDP in the merger that brought APC. So these are the people that broke away from their former party and join us after we have already strategized everything on how to win our election. Their contribution is very minimal. President Buhari defeated PDP, not new PDP. So, and I want to tell you, that is why, to me, I am not saying it is a general opinion. To me, I want them to go so that after 2019, we can tell them that 2015, these are your contributions. And now it's because they are in the party, that is why they are making out. They break away from there to join the winning trend, and we went together. Quite of course, they have contributed in their various states. But to me, whether they remain in the party, whether they leave, the best thing for us is for them to leave. That is it. And I'm assuring you, 2019, the same party that delivered in 2015 will still win the same PDP and other parties in 2019. Check it very well. If these people are really trying to form a political party, they should have done that since. Why are they staying on the fence? They said reform PDP. What is reform APC? What is reform APC? We have the APC. Even the initial APC, they were not part of it. Are they in APC, CPC? Are they in ACN? Are they in ANPP? So what makes to be reform APC? Why can't they call themselves reform PDP since they came from PDP? APC belongs to those people that come from the three major political parties that form APC. So not somebody that just come from PDP or call himself a new PDP when he was thrown out of PDP to come and claim being a reform APC. So to me, their contribution is very minimal. To me, I don't even think it's important for them to remain in the party. And I am appealing to the national secretary of this party and the national chairman, Adam Oshomole, to do away with these people. Otherwise, they may end up being a distraction. This is a style. They want to keep on distracting the party. They will not allow things to move.
All right.
And we cannot allow these people to hold us to ransom. So since they have decided, whatever the case may be, at the end of the day, they will break away and they will go. So let them go now.
All right.
So that we can see.
All right, Mr. Garba Umar, thank you very much for joining us on the program. Garba Umar, who is the secretary of the Buhari Youth Organization there. We'll take a short break, and when we come back, we'll continue this discussion.